some houses are made using bricks and cement, glass and wood, but the house I'm in right now is made using a different material. This house is made out of... cardboard! It's a cardboard playhouse. Paper and cardboard are used to make lots of different things inside our homes. Wallpaper, toilet paper, packaging, cardboard boxes. But how has this playhouse been made out of cardboard? To find out, I've come here, Trywall in Monmouth, Wales. And we're going to begin at the start of its journey, where it began like this. Enormous rolls of paper. And each one weighs about the same as a car. Sort of looks like toilet roll for giants, doesn't it? Paper is a really useful material, and this factory has stacks of the stuff. In fact, since this company started, and I cannot believe I'm saying this, it's made 173 million miles of cardboard. That's even further than the distance from planet Earth, past the moon, and the asteroid belt, all the way to Mars.
So cardboard is made from lots of paper, but where does it all come from? Well, most new paper starts its life as a tree. First, a tree has to be cut down or felled, and the bark is removed so you don't get bits of chunky wood in your paper. But let's not forget that trees are essential for life on Earth. So it's important that we replace them if we're using trees to make paper, cardboard, and of course, cardboard playhouses. It's pretty cool that this factory have replanted over 500,000 trees. Where were we? Oh yeah, next the logs are crushed up into fibres and water is added to create a wood pulp, a bit like a papery porridge mix. It gets blended with dye to make the paper the right colour before all the liquid is drained off and squeezed out by big rollers until only the fibres are left. Then it's dried and kept flat before being made into sheets of paper or rolled onto big reels.
Once the paper has been made in a mill, it arrives here at the factory's warehouse where it can begin its journey to becoming cardboard. Reels of paper are fed onto this huge machine called a reel stand, which you can think of a bit like a giant toilet roll holder. The paper is pulled off the reel stand and it loops over a set of rollers and makes its way inside here, where you find a single facer machine. And the job of a single facer is to turn this paper into corrugated cardboard. Now, corrugated cardboard has three layers of paper, two walls, and a wavy layer in the middle. But why would you want it to be wavy?
Well, once upon a time, wavy or corrugated cardboard was used for this. Good day. Top hats. Fun fact for you, corrugated cardboard was actually invented to give top hats their shape, but now it has a lot more uses. But first, let's start with a single sheet of cardboard, not a wave in sight, and look how easy it is to rip. No trouble at all. But if we compare that to the corrugated cardboard, which has three layers, we have the top and bottom piece of paper, they're called the liners, and then in the middle, we have the wavy bit, that's usually called the fluting. If I try to tear it, I can barely make it budge. Combining the paper in layers like this makes the corrugated cardboard much stronger.
This single facer machine has been turned off so we can get a closer look. But you can see how the paper comes in flat and then it goes through a set of rollers that are corrugated. And when the paper goes through those rollers, they're a bit like two rows of teeth. It makes the paper wavy, or like we say here, it's what gives the paper its flute. Then we have a flat piece of paper, the fluted piece, and another flat piece that are stuck together with this gloopy stuff. It's a type of glue, but it's actually made out of corn. This is the treble backer machine, and it glues together three layers of corrugated card that come from the three single facer machines. And when they're all glued together, it looks a little bit like this. The more layers the corrugated cardboard has, the sturdier it is. paper to triple wall cardboard in a matter of minutes.
Ooh.
Let's not forget, cardboard is also an eco-friendly material, easily recycled and reused. Back here at the Gotford machine, we can see the waste chute. This nozzle works like a giant vacuum, sucking up all of the offcuts and waste material, ready to be recycled.
The offcuts travel through the factory by pipes, and any damaged paper or leftover packaging all gets fed into this machine called a shredder. Here, everything gets chopped up.
And it's very noisy! Once it's all been shredded into little bits, it goes into this big blue hopper and then drops down into this machine that's called a baler. And this is squeezing the waste paper into giant paper building blocks. All of these paper blocks will be sent to a recycling plant that can turn this back into a huge reel of paper that can be used here to make even more cardboard. Nothing gets wasted. Sustainability is so important here that even the paper dust waste is recycled. It gets collected and then squeezed into these little briquettes. And believe it or not, this waste paper dust can go on to become this type of packaging, the very same that makes cereal boxes. So we know that cardboard is a brilliant material, but what about our playhouse? All of this cardboard is looking a bit flat. Take a look at this. It's a digital image of our flat 2D playhouse ready to be cut out on the cutting table. The playhouse will be completely cut out by this, a CNC machine, not a pair of scissors in sight. And to get it started, all I have to do is press the big green button. Here goes. Ooh! The digital image is sent from the computer to the CNC machine, telling it exactly what shape to cut out. It's starting with a wheel that's rolling all of the lines to make sure they're just right before a small blade goes along those lines and cuts everything out. It's finished! Ta-da! A playhouse! Kind of. Thankfully, my friends Kurt and Emily are here to help me pop this out so we can build it. Right, I'll take this bit. Sweet home, my own little cardboard playhouse. Oh, do come on in. That's it, come on in. We'll definitely both fit. Come on. Well, here it is, complete with windows and doors. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe for more, stay curious, and I'll see you soon. Bye. And I'll say a line. I just don't know what I'll say. I don't know what I just did, but I'm pretty sure I made the Gotford machine work. So much cardboard. Ooh, it's moving. Okay. So they look like that. Cool. Now we'll do a finishing piece to camera. Yeah?